हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन डायग्राम फॉर डक्टाइल मटेरियल और माइल्ड स्टील। सो लेट अस सी फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन। इन ए डिजाइनिंग वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ ए मशीन, इट इज नेसेसरी टू नो हाउ द मटेरियल विल फंक्शन इन सर्विस। For this, certain characteristics or properties of the material should be known. The mechanical properties mostly used in mechanical engineering practice are commonly determined from a standard tensile test. This test consists of gradually loading a standard specimen of a material and noting the corresponding values of load and elongation until the specimen fractures. So this is the stress strain diagram for mild steel or ductile material. On the x-axis, strain values are there. On y-axis, stress values are there. You can see in the diagram, as a load increases, stress also increases. As a load increases, elongation increases. That means stress is nothing but load divided by area. That is, if load increases, stress also increases. And strain is nothing but change in length to the original length. That is, as a change in length increases, strain also increases. So from point O to P, there is linear relationship between stress and strain, and from P to point up there is a non-linear relationship between stress and strain. So let us see the properties obtained from stress strain diagram. So first is proportional limit, that is P, point P. Second is elastic limit, that is point E. Third is modulus of elasticity, that is capital E. Fourth is yield strength, that is Y1 and Y2. Fifth is ultimate tensile strength, which is obtained at point U. Sixth is modulus of resilience. Seventh is modulus of toughness. Eight is percentage elongation. And nine is percentage reduction in area. So let us see one by one. First point is proportional limit. It is observed from the diagram that stress strain relationship is linear from point O to P. Stress strain relationship is linear from point O to P. OP is a straight line, and after the point P, the curve begins to deviate from the straight line. After point P, curve begins to deviate from the straight line. Hooke's law stated that within elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Therefore, it is applicable only up to point P. The term proportional limit is defined as the stress at which the stress strain curve begins to deviate from the straight line. That point from where the curve begins to deviate from the straight line, that point is called as proportional limit. Point P indicates the proportional limit in this diagram. Now, the second point is elastic limit. Even if the specimen is stressed beyond the point P and up to the point E, it will regain its initial size and shape when the load is removed. So up to point E, material will regain its original shape and size after removal of external force. So this indicates that the material is in elastic stage up to the point E. Therefore, E is called as elastic limit. The elastic limit of the material is defined as the maximum stress without any permanent deformation. So up to point PE, there is no permanent deformation. So that point E is called as elastic limit. Now the next point is, third point is modulus of elasticity. What is modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus? The modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus E is the ratio of stress to the strain up to the point P. It is given by the slope of the line OP. So therefore, E is equal to tan theta. You can see the angle theta of OP line makes an angle theta with respect to x axis, and E is equal to tan theta. So tan theta is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. It is Px divided by Px. Therefore, E is equal to Px is nothing but stress value and Ox is nothing but strain value. So E is equal to stress divided by strain. Next point, fourth point is yield strength. When the specimen is stressed beyond the E, point E, plastic deformation occurs and the material starts yielding. After point E, plastic deformation occurs and material starts yielding. During this stage, it is not possible to recover the initial size and shape of the specimen on the removal of load. So there is, it is not possible to recover the initial size and shape after point E. The points Y1 and Y2 are called the upper and lower yield points respectively. The yield strength is defined as the maximum stress at which a marked increase in elongation occurs without increasing the load. So you can see at point Y1, Y2, there is no increase in stress, but there is increase in strain. Then the next point, fifth point, is ultimate tensile strength. After the yield point Y2, plastic deformation of the specimen increases. After point Y2, plastic deformation of the specimen increases. The material becomes stronger due to strain hardening. Now, after point Y2, strain hardening is there, and due to that, material becomes stronger and higher load is required to deform the material. Higher and higher load is required to deform the material after point Y2. Therefore, you can see the curve from Y2 to U point U. There is increase in stress with increase in strain. Finally, the load and corresponding stress reach a maximum value as given by point U. So at point U, the load and corresponding stress reach a maximum value. The stress corresponding the point U is called the ultimate strength. The ultimate tensile strength is nothing but the maximum stress that can be reached in the tension test. So ultimate strength means maximum stress that can be reached in the tension test. Then sixth point is modulus of resilience. So what is modulus of resilience? You can see in the diagram. This is also stress strain diagram for a ductile material, and you can see the hatching area. It shows the modulus of resilience. So resilience is defined as the ability of the material to absorb energy when deformed elastically and to release this energy when unloaded. So resilience is nothing but ability of material to absorb energy up to elastic limit and release this energy when unloaded. This property is essential for spring materials. So in the design of spring, this property is important. Resilience is measured by quantity called modulus of resilience. So resilience is measured by quantity, modulus of resilience, which is strain energy per unit volume measured up to elastic limit, and it is represented by area under stress strain curve from the origin to the elastic limit point. Then the next point is modulus of toughness. Seventh point is modulus of toughness. Now what is meant by toughness? So toughness is defined as the ability of material to absorb energy before fracture takes place. So resilience means ability to absorb energy up to point E. But toughness is nothing but the ability of material to absorb energy up to fracture takes place. So up to point E up. Now this toughness is measured by a quantity called as modulus of toughness. So modulus of toughness is the total area under stress strain curve in tension test, which also represents the work done to fracture the specimen. Then the next 8th point is percentage elongation. What is percentage elongation? Is defined as the ratio of increase in the length of the gauge section of a specimen to the original gauge length expressed in percent. So therefore percentage elongation is equal to L minus L naught divided by L naught into 100. So ductility is measured by percentage elongation. And the last point is percentage reduction in area. So what is percentage reduction in area? It is defined as the ratio of decrease in cross-sectional area of the specimen after fracture to the original cross-sectional area expressed in percent. Therefore, percentage reduction in area is equal to A0 minus A divided by A0 into 100. Thank you.